Hello everyone and welcome back guys to episode 4 of our DiRT 3 Let's Play, where today we're here back finishing off the Season 1, I guess you probably should call it, on this game. We have completely completed the Alpine Stars Trophy, the Brembo Blast and the Rockstar Transworld Clash, so all we have got left to do is the Gymkhana Finals. Very, very much looking forward to be jumping into this. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 six events, even I should say, to finish this. So we're going to need to try and get platinum on all of them to earn all the RP that we need. But obviously, if this is a video that you go on to enjoy, make sure you leave a like. It really, really does help me out. And subscribe if you are new around here as well.
Okay, ready for your big surprise? I want you to meet your new Gymkhana instructor, 3-time X Games medalist and YouTube sensation, racing superstar, Ken Block.
Hey, what's up?
If you haven't seen this guy's videos, you're missing out on some really sick driving. Ken is the best Gymkhana driver on the planet, and he's also one of the sport's biggest innovators. He single-handedly raised the profile of the sport.
Come on, Christian, you're making me blush.
Just telling you how it is, my amigo. Okay. So once you learn how to do Gymkhana, we'll start setting challenges for you. So be sure to pay attention to everything Ken says.
All right, let's get you out there and up to speed. This is going to be fun.
Nice. Welcome to Gymkhana School, Ken Block style.
So here we go then. Ready for our first challenge here in Gymkhana. 40,000 points. To pass, but obviously we're going for platinum.
Training them by smashing things. What's this all about, Ken?
Well, smash blocks is the simplest trick you're gonna learn about. Just drive into them and you'll get points for each one you smash. Simple as that.
Maximum destruction. All right, Ken's shown you how it's done. Just smash enough blocks to get a bronze medal and move on to the next tutorial. Go smash it.
Not aim for bronze, we're aiming for platinum. So we need 200,000 points for platinum. Don't know how many that means. I guess obviously we're going to need to smash all of them. Although it's always that horrible thing of picking your routes. But yeah, we, like I said, going to try and score as many points as possible. We got 2 minutes, I think it was, on the clock, but we don't have enough time to check. Oh god, where are we going? Need to go this way. Ooh. Don't know if we're going to fall to the... Well, we'll find out in a minute if we can afford to leave any of them. But yeah, it's probably going to be... Oh, it's only 200,000 points, sorry, not 220. We're already at 153k, so we're not doing too badly. 162k.
Nice driving, amigo.
Oh, so we don't get very long either to do it then. This, yeah, might be a bit more difficult than I originally thought it would be. We're just going to need to try and go around and smash them all. There we go! 201k in the end. You basically, yeah, you needed perfection on that one to be able to get that. So these are, yeah, going to be quite difficult, I think, in all honesty. But we'll wait and see as to just how difficult it does end up being. But I mean, there's 1,000 rep on the line for each one, which is certainly quite useful to have as well at the end of the day. But that's challenge one completed, the easiest of the lot. Next up is, ooh, that might be a bit easier. Jumps, I'm guessing. I hope. We'll wait and see.
Now this is what I'm talking about. Jumps and getting tons of air. Any tips for our driver, Ken?
Well, they're really pretty easy. The trick is to find the right line into the jump. Get as much speed as you dare for some big air time. Be careful, though, as you'll need to keep it under control on the landing.
So the further you fly, the higher the score. Look out for the triangles to tell you how well you did. 3 triangles means you aced the trick and got maximum points.
Sounds good, so I'm guessing it's just going to be going backwards and forwards a few times then, try and pick up as many points as possible. So 45k is the target, but we've only got half a minute. But you can get up to 10,000, so we basically just need another... No, you can't quite get as well as I thought you could. Only picking up sort of 8k, it's that... Oh, come on, don't do that. Yeah, it's going to be one of those ones we got to try and get far enough in one direction. 43k, yeah, so we just need to try and get far enough in one direction to be able to get the points going back. Basically, all it requires is to get over 5k on this one, which every time you get 5,750, unless you somehow pulls it up. And then you're just going to try and get 10k over the rest of them, without understeering why you're into that. A little bit early there, but that's okay. Oh no, 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 no. Right, rewind. Come on. Just gotta get a little bit further back on the entry. Really just gotta try and open up that corner as much as possible. Was that over? No, not quite. Trying to do the mental maths in my head there. I think we're about 500 points off. But obviously it's that horrible balance about trying to get onto the jump again as well. And trying to pick up enough points. Nope. So what it's getting to. We don't often use the rewinds like this, but these sorts of events basically just require perfection, so you might as well, rather than spending an hour. Oh no. That's not what you want. Obviously, we have only got the 5 rewinds as well, so we've got to be careful. We'll slam on the anchors now. Right, cool. Power. That should be it. There we go. 45,750. Basically, I think the maximum you can get on that one. Once again, you could just clutch the platforms. But we're 2 so far out of 6. This one definitely feels like more of a grind than any of the standard episodes. But obviously we get all the XP. We'd already picked up the other 800 from the gold. Next up is DiRT, if I'm not mistaken. We accidentally obviously unlocked that earlier on. So yeah, we've got 3 more standards and then whatever the final one is. But we're getting there. Slowly but surely. It's just about trying to work out how to get the run.
Ah, drifting. That's how you get the crowd going. Tell us how it's done, Ken.
Okay, these are drift gates. There's a few different kinds, but they all work the same way. Just slide through them fast and with the car at an angle. The faster and the more sideways you drift through the gate, the more points you'll score.
Awesome. Go get your slide on, amigo.
Seems pretty simple, but we have struggled with the drift mechanics in the past, so wait and see how this goes. I'm basically guessing it's just going to be a figure of 8. 145k, though, is what we need. There we go. 145,370. Once again, we've just scraped it. I think that one, there is a little bit more leeway, obviously, with just the drift mechanics on this game. I think if you absolutely nail it, you could probably get upwards of 160k, but we've got the platinum. That's all we've come here for. So we are slowly but surely getting there. We're halfway through all the standard challenges, but I'm very... Oh, sorry, no, we've only got one more to go. No, we're only just over halfway through even. So spin control, and then one more. So this one, I think, is the tumble dryer, as it was known back in the day. But yeah, two more to go then. Hopefully we can just try and get a good run.
Now, spin zones look impossible to me. A real demonstration of precision driving. What's the trick of pulling these off, Ken?
Well, the spin zone's actually one of my favorite tricks. You need to drive into the marked area and get the car into a controlled spin. The more you spin, the more you'll score. The key is to approach slowly and at an angle. Then turn in and use the handbrake to get the back end out. Keep your foot on the gas and steer hard to keep it going.
The longer the spin, the higher you score. If you max it out or start getting dizzy, just straighten up and drive off. The crowds love this stuff.
Seems fairly simple then. We gotta get 100,000 points. There you go. There's 10k. So I'm basically just gonna be swapping between these two then. I used to find these quite fun to do, I'll be honest, but we'll wait and see as to how this goes. Come on. Come on. Oh, that was so close.
A gold medal.
That was impossibly close. No! Again? Seriously? It's rigged.
Can you believe it?
It's rigged against me.
Of course you can.
There we go. Took long enough, but we finally got there. 100,000 points gets us the platinum medal. We had so many attempts where we barely missed out. But we did it this time. One more normal challenge to go then.
Fancy a donut? In the world of Gymkhana, that word means something entirely different, right, Ken?
Yeah, we've got big and small donuts here. They may look different, but they all work the same way. You just need to pull off a smooth, sideways drift around the central object. To get started, drive up like you're going past the trick, then get your car sideways by turning in hard and using the handbrake. Next, balance the throttle and the steering to keep your nose as close to the center as possible while you spin.
Remember, you can only score points off the marked Gymkhana donuts. They look pretty tricky, but I got faith. Better get to it.
Well, if it's anything like the other ones, then we're gonna struggle, but we'll wait and see. Might have to try and go between these two. Oh god. There we go. Not there. I wonder, can you just donut off one of them? No. Yes, but it takes too long. Thank you. Well, that one ended up being, despite a poor run, actually a platinum medal.
What's the matter?
You just got to try and work out the right routine to go with, but we're 5 for 5 on the standard ones. Nice 20G achievement there as well, things you'll love to see. And now we've just got one more challenge to go then, and I feel like it's going to be tough.
Christian and Ken tell me you handled the Gymkhana training like a pro. Great, let's see what you can do. For the final event of the season, I've entered you into a competitive Gymkhana event.
What a killer way to wrap up your first season. You're totally ready to tear it up. This is going to be off the hook.
You'll need to finish in the top 3 in order to qualify for the next season. Don't let me down.
Right, so actually this one might not be so bad.
It's fresh, it's new, it's loud, and it's bright. Starting out in the days when there was nothing but a couple of cones in a car park, Gymkhana now takes the center stage with custom-built arenas, mad crowds, and everything that is sick. The top drivers around the world all compete to sign their names in rubber and get the crowds going wild. Gymkhana is all about expression and personality. Make it your own, and you'll have some fans for life. You're gonna love this one, amigo.
Right, so if we can win this 2,000 rep as well, but obviously that'll give us Season 2, and everything from Season 1 will be finished. Hopefully a gold. Obviously, where there being no platinums should be attainable, but we'll wait and see what the top scores are like.
Alright, you've learned all the tricks, but now comes the real challenge. You've got to string them all together and compete in a freestyle Gymkhana event. These events are all about putting on a show for the fans. Keep the crowd hooked, and this will act as a multiplier on your trick scores, earning you anywhere up to triple points. Ken, what's the key to keeping the crowd on your side?
Well, there's 3 main things you'll want to remember. First, minimize your downtime by stringing tricks together as quickly as you can. Second, don't repeat the same tricks too much, or the crowd will get bored. And finally, don't crash. Smashing up your car shows a lack of control. Once you're out there, everything I taught you will all fall into place. So don't worry, and good luck.
We'll be rooting for you, buddy. Give them a show they'll never forget.
Right, let's do this thing then. Don't know what the score is that we need to beat. They're normally close to 500,000, but you also obviously get 3-time multipliers. So hopefully we can just smash this. No, 165k. That seems a lot more manageable. Let's do this thing. Normally the blocks are a good thing, obviously just for easy points. There you go, to level 2. Things you'd love to see. Up to level 3. It's all gone wrong, but I mean, we've already got the gold score by twice than anyone else, so. There we go, 350k, sorry. So we doubled anyone else's score there in
your
the end.
Will go nuts,
and that is gonna
that.
Be.
Let's post it on YouTube.
Season 1 of Dirt Rally 2.0 completed.
Hey, you did a great job out there. I'm looking forward to competing against you soon. I reckon I've got some real competition on my hands.
You definitely have, Ken. You better look out. Way to represent, my friend. The fans are loving it, and so am I.
What a way to end the season. I can't believe how well you did. I knew I made the right choice in signing you. Congratulations.
There we go. Season 1, 100% completed. We can tick that off the books. Kenny from the block. thinks we might be a good challenge for him in the future as well. 2,000 rep as well should take us over the level 8 mark. What are we going to get an offer from? Garmin Motorsport. Good team to have in the books.
Congratulations on surviving your first pro season. As your reward, DC has given you access to something very exclusive.
You're in the big leagues now, muchacho. This is one serious perk of the job. We're turning the Battersea compound into a driving nirvana for you to sharpen your skills or simply cut loose and have a little fun. We just renovated the parking lot. Here you can drift the donut to your heart's content. Oh, and look out for the awesome four-way jump we put in. You totally gotta check it out.
So there we go. We'll be certainly giving that one a whirl further down the line as well. But I think for now, we've got
definitely not a rookie
season
anymore,
2.
But it's time to prove to the world that you're a legitimate driver or risk becoming a one-hit wonder. Only way to do that is to get out there and keep grabbing podiums.
Agreed. Interest in you has grown, so you have a choice between two championships to start off the season. Have a look.
So, we've got the option between two championships this time round. Have a look. We got Rally, Trailblazer is going to be good fun, I remember that. And then some other stuff. And then also we have got the Osiris, Off-Road Rush. Again, looking at the same sort of stuff as well. But obviously we'll be going through completing those in the near future. Thank you all so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy, do make sure you get yourself subscribed. And look at that, all gold here for Season 1. It's something you absolutely love to see. And yeah, we will be back very, very soon then, where we will be taking on the Smith's Optics Rampage.